Good morning, students. Today's topic is ophiolytics, the practical session that we are going to deal with today. So we had stopped till the anode and asterisk. So the next continuation of practicals is trace ophiolytics. Okay, so it's commonly called as brittle cells. All of you know that, isn't it? So first we'll go with the classification. As we all know, echinoderm classification. Phylum Echinoderm, class Ophiolaria, and order is Ophiuria, and the species or the genus is the Ophiolex. Okay, so this is the brittle star diagram that I have drawn. Okay, so the one complete arm with the spines that I have drawn. Okay, so this is the spines, this is the central mouth. Okay, and you have the teeth surrounded by the mouth. Okay, so we can write as teeth is nothing but the jaw. Okay, so sorry, the jaw which is supposed to bear the teeth, but here we have only the hard teeth, like hard structure, which is nothing but the jaw. Okay, so teeth as such is not there, and these jaws, hard jaws, are going to function as a teeth only. It is going to grab the organism and push the food inside the mouth. Okay, so the next here is the these two small structures around the mouth, we call it as a podial pores. Okay, and here you have the arm sheaths. Okay, so the arm has a sheath for the protection. Okay, so these two are the arm sheaths. And this is the arm. Okay, and you have a central disc. This is the central disc, and you have spines around it also. Okay, so this is the shield or the central disc that you could call and this is the oral shield. This is the oral sheath and this is the central disc. This is the oral sheath. Okay, so the protection of it. Fine. So we'll deal with the general characters first. So we have seen the diagram and we could visualize how the organism looks like. Okay, it somewhat looks like a star, and you have the arms as that of the asterisk. But what is the difference between the asterisk and the brittle star? Okay, we should know that difference. So here basically the main difference from that of the asterisk and this is it does not have the ambulacral grooves, pedicellariae, and the other structures which we had shown in case of the asterisk. Okay, so the spines which are there on the oral surface and the lower surface, ambulacral grooves, all those are absent in case of the brittle star. Okay, so that is the major difference between the asterisk and the brittle star, or nothing but the ophiolites. Okay, so basically, where do they live? Habitat. So habitat, we know echinoderms are exclusively in marine forests, correct? In the marine, that is in the ocean, which is the region that they occupy. Usually, they are the crawling type of an animals, which will usually prefer the beneath layer, isn't it? The bottom layer, bottom surface of the ocean. So then, whatever they get, okay, they are the gregarious feeders, meaning whatever they get, seaweeds or any other invertebrates. This is also an invertebrate, but the smaller creatures of the invertebrates, it just engulfs it inside. Okay, so it eats varieties of food. It is not a particular feeder. It is going to feed on the seaweeds, it is going to feed on the organisms that is coming across it. Okay, the smaller invertebrates. Then, they are of different colors. They are of yellow color, orange color, okay, many colors, but most common colors that we would see is the grayish color brittle stars we would find. Okay, so then coming to the structure as such. As already I have explained you the structure of it, we know that And the jaws are, the spine like hard jaw is present throughout the mouth. And the mouth is surrounded by a central, mouth is surrounded by an oral sheath. Oral sheath and the mouth is present in the central disc. Okay, this central disc is about 20 mm. Okay, it's a very small disc. But the arms are 5 times larger than that of the diameter of the central disc. Say, like, suppose if this is the particular length, it is 5 times bigger. Okay, here since the space constraint, I couldn't draw a longer arms. But, the actual size of the particular brittle star is like that. Okay, the calculation goes like that. Then, after the central disc has the podial pores. The podial pores which we had already learned in the asterisk or the common features. Podial vesicles, do you remember? Those are the vesicles when we were studying about the water vascular system, which will help in the storage of the water sometimes. So these are the podial vesicles which you could see it clearly in case of the brittle star, since there is no ambulacral groove system. Okay, so the ambulacral grooves and pedicellial absent here. Okay, we could see only the podial pores very clearly and the prominently. And then, see, you have a bristle slits. These are the slits which are going to give rise to a particular arm. Okay, and then arm will extend to form an arm sheath, that is a smaller slits. And then there is a completely, the arm is surrounded by irregular, sharp, movable spines. Okay, this is going to actually help in capturing the food. Okay, so these 5 arms, the arms might be 5 or 2, 7. 5 to 7 arm brittle stars we could find. Okay, but the standard one, we would prefer 5 arm one. So this is completely covered with the spines here. Okay, so then how to identify the specimen? Correct, no? So see, and the other characters is like sexes are separate, external fertilization is like the same characters goes good with the brittle star also. The chimerotome characters will be going good with the brittle star also. So oral surface is there, aboral surface is there, oral surface, mouth is present, and you have aboral surface, anus is present. So everything is the same. It holds good for the same. A brittle star and the asterisk. Okay, so then how to identify a specimen? So here we have a specimen. Okay, so if we could see that the specimen which we are going to keep it during your exam, you have seen this. So you could find make the same replica of this. See, when you see a diagram or when you see a specimen, it is not so looking very neat, beautiful. More of spines are seen. Okay, throughout the central disc you could find the spines, and you could find in the arms also spines. Something little a pricky kind of an animal. Okay, so you could find that the organism is more of spines, fully filled spines, and the arms are of 5 or up to 7. Here the specimen which we have also has the 5 arms. Okay, and very prominently you could see the central disc. That is one of the important features that you could identify it as a brittle star. Okay, and the spines are very slender. Okay, very thin. See, here you could make out that it is 5 times bigger than that of the central disc. See, here the arms are very long arms you could find, and the central disc is the smaller central disc. Okay, so this is how, and the grayish color specimen that we have. Okay, and these are bottom layers, well, sessile, they look to be very independent. And so in this way you could identify this particular kind of a specimen. Okay, very light grayish, 5 arm, fully filled with spines. Okay, and the central disc you could see, which is through which the pentaradial arm that you could see. Okay, that is the 5 arms pentaradius. Okay, so 5 arms that you could see, which is radiating from the central disc. Okay, so this is how you identify it, and most commonly found in which annual areas that you could country, that is the western coast. Okay, mostly in the British islands you could find these kinds of brittle stars more larger in number, otherwise it is found throughout the oceans. Okay, so thank you. Here ends up the topics. If you have any doubts, you can reach on the comment section or you can text us.